again, everyone, and welcome to the Bob Simmons Show. I'm Tom Dirato, and the Cowboys wrapped up the road portion of the schedule this past weekend. And, Bob, it was a long day at the office in Lubbock, Texas.
Well, it was, Tom. You know, team went down there, and obviously that first half, I thought that we had a chance to put some points on the board. You know, we had the ball 21 minutes to 8, and you look up at the scoreboard, and it's 28 to nothing.
We talked about it after the game, but that fourth and inches there, a motion penalty results in a field goal attempt. They run it back after blocking it. That was really the swing to kind of carry them into the win.
Big play in the ball game because we actually score on that call by the officials because one of our linemen ended up jumping just before the snap. Then we come out and decide to go for a field goal, and they block that and run it back. And, you know, instead of being 7-7 at that point, it's 14 to nothing. And that was a big swing. And so we need to have something good happen to us.
And there were some good things that happened. You don't roll up 257 yards in one half and not have guys step up and make some plays.
No, you don't. When you talk about 52 plays in a half, I know talking to our offensive coordinator and offensive staff, you know, they've talked about, well, we've never had the ball that many times and there were no points on the board. So, you know, one of those times of games, Tom, that the 10 penalties did hurt us. That we needed to be consistent and really on both sides of the ball to have that game come out our way.
Well, your day at the office was made just a little longer yesterday, and that's one of the reasons you're casually dressed here. You got a knee injury out of this as well as you got rolled up on the sideline, and you're going to get your first look at it from up top, and boom.
Yeah, you know, I used to be quicker than that, but.
Well, you're going to see how quick you were on the replay
you
here.
I thought I stepped out of the way, and then I think that was Albert Craig came in and caught my knee underneath me, and that's why I'm dressed this way.
And what's your injury status right now?
Well, I'm going to get an MRI tomorrow. Right now, it's swollen up, and so we hope that the MRI doesn't show that it's very
serious. We don't
need
to be putting you on the
disabled
list. No, we
don't. Not at this point.
But while it has been a hard year for everyone concerned, there are a number of OSU players who are having solid years. No question about that. And we're going to show you some of those when we return to the Bob Simmons Show.
For the most complete, up-to-date, and accurate information on your Oklahoma State Cowboys, your internet destination is www.okstate.com, the official athletic website of Oklahoma State University.
Welcome back to the show, and Bob, we had mentioned there are a lot of individuals who have had solid years this year, and that's one of the reasons we want to show some of these individuals here this week to show that, hey, there's been some good things that have happened this year, and a good portion of those guys are back next season.
Well, it is, Tom. Obviously, when you look at the guys that you're showing, and there's a number of guys, but, you know, Reggie's on pace right now to end up getting 1,000 yards this year, and he's had a fantastic year, 73 yards away, and he's being helped by an offensive line, you know, Brian Phillips and Jeff Machado, Vandrell, all those guys are back, you know, and there's some young guys back there, Russell. So the offensive line that will be intact, but, you know, Reggie's going to be one of the premier backs in this conference.
He turned into be a pretty reliable receiver the last couple of weeks.
Well, you know, Reggie's always had good hands, and one thing that will make him special is that one guy, he's learned to really run through tackles. One guy's not going to bring him down. And really what you have is a guy that 225, 30 pounds with a lot of speed. And also has really got a great future. Guy that studies quite a bit in terms of learning the game. He continues to get better in terms of really making good decisions and throwing the ball down the field. He's got a strong arm. He's got great qualities as a leader, as a quarterback, because he's got good presence in the huddle, which is important for a quarterback.
He's got a legitimate chance to be the all-time single-season passing leader in school history for a freshman.
Well, he does, and he's a guy that I think in the upcoming years, along with Rashawn Woods and Gabe Lindsey, who are guys that are playing this year, all those core back, I think Fobbs, and Marcellus has a chance to come back. It'll be up to him. But as he surveys at the end of the year what he wants to do, if he's on track to graduate, he can actually come back for that last season, and that would be a benefit to the program. But Iso will be a big, strong quarterback with a great future.
He got a chance, an opportunity. stepped up and took advantage of it this year. That's what you'd like to see. How about this guy coming around now?
Well, you know, this guy will keep the Lindsey name going because Gabe will be an exciting punt return guy. And the thing that he does well is he's got the ability to make people miss. He really got good quickness. As you saw in the last ball game against Texas A&M, where he took the punt return back all the way. And he's a winner, very much a competitor, a person that I think in the upcoming years that we'll make a lot of big plays for you because he's got good hands. You know, he can take his body and move it around and get in good position. Here you see where you know, he puts that ball in the right hand as after he comes back to the field, and that's the first touchdown against A&M that they've had in, I don't know, what do you say, 360
some odd game and punt return games, touchdowns,
punt
that's
return.
Correct.
So Gabe Lindsey's going to have a good future here. And
switch
this guy's leaving.
Defense, huh?
Yeah, he's on his way out, though. Thomas is. He's a senior, and I think that he'll be a guy that guys will read about in the upcoming years in the NFL because he does have the kind of speed and quickness that they look for at the linebacker position. And it's having a pretty decent season for us.
Almost a third of his tackles are behind the line of scrimmage.
Right, and the thing that he does so well, or can do, is really with the speed and quickness be a factor in making plays as you see here. So he's got two games left, and obviously I think he really wants to finish up on a positive note with this game coming up with Baylor as well as our game coming up with OU.
And again, a lot of guys we should mention didn't have time to show each and every one, but there again, I think you see the strength that he has right there. He can run with the guys who are supposedly skilled people. He can run with them and stay right with them. Here, Dwayne Levels, another guy who plays hard.
Well, when you talk about a general on the defensive squad and a guy that has been the leader of that defense in terms of getting guys lined up as well as performing at the top level, his levels. And because he's a guy that's very similar to Osso, he comes in and studies film and obviously get a good feel for what the defense is all about and really commands a lot of respect from our older and younger guys. And so I like Dwayne Levels and what he brings to the table from a leadership standpoint and just the fact that, you know, when he comes to the office, he comes to work. And that's kind of guy that this defense is going to have in Levels when he comes back next year
and
finishes up this year. He's got a couple games to go. And again, he's a guy that's got a lot of fire in him. A good person for a good example for people to follow, and so is this guy T. Rob because he
up and comer, and
he's got a lot of fire in him. And as you see early in the season, he's a guy that flies around and can cause a lot of things to happen. He's a young guy that he's getting held.
Think he'd been held a little bit right there. Put the jersey back
right.
on.
But he is a young guy that continues to learn. And I think it's going to be a mainstay. He's a first-year player. Time when you talk about losing those seven seniors last year, here's a guy that has stepped in. And the more he plays, I think the better off this defense is going to be because the value in his experience will be shown next year.
I think that says a lot about the kids that you and your staff have brought in over the last 4 or 5 years. The guys are now stepping up and taking on all the important roles.
Well, and there's been a bunch of kids that we really hadn't talked
right.
about. We really hadn't talked about our redshirt freshmen, which there's a lot of class guys in that freshman class that come in. And as I said, for the offensive line, so, you know, as you and I talked about, there'll be a lot of kids coming back that's going to help this program.
You know, if all the highlight tapes that we have done over the years, we get the most requests to repeat and, yes, even sell the 1988 tape. On this week's 2-Minute Drill, we'll bring back our tribute to Barry Sanders. And as usual, it's brought to you by Oklahoma Farm Bureau Insurance.
The 1988 winner of the Heisman Award is Barry Sanders of Oklahoma State University.
I thank God for putting me in this position. You know, I couldn't have done it without him. And secondly, I'd like to thank my offensive line and my fullback, Garrett Limbrick. You know, they've done such a great job. You know, I couldn't ask for a better season out of those guys. And, you know, I'd like to thank William and Shirley Sanders for being so inspirational in my life and bringing me up the way they know I should be brought up. Thanks a lot.
each day I live.
The name is Barry Sanders. He plays football at Oklahoma State University. In 1988, he put together a season which can only be described as incredible.
But not alone.
His breathtaking performance is one sure to etch an indelible memory. One moment in time. The 1988 edition of the Oklahoma State Cowboys was a truly remarkable one, featuring an offense that simply ran roughshod over its opposition. It was a team laden with star performers, but in 1988, none shone more brightly than the consensus All-America junior tailback from Wichita. By overwhelming mandate, the finest collegiate football player in the country. They call Barry Sanders the Kansas Comet, as anyone who has had the unfortunate task of trying to catch this 5'8", 197-pound dynamo can tell you, his is an appropriate nickname. A dream season, a once-in-a-lifetime achievement. There's simply no other description for Barry Sanders' 1988 campaign. One in which he shattered records many thought untouchable. Sanders' storybook season saw him establish or tie 24 new NCAA standards. Among the most noteworthy, 2,553 yards rushing, surpassing the single season record held by Marcus Allen of USC. 234 points and 39 touchdowns, obliterating the mark shared by Penn State's Lydell Mitchell and Mike Rozier of Nebraska. 3,249 all-purpose yards, easily erasing one of the oldest NCAA records, that formerly held by Supreme Court Justice Byron Whizzer White, an All-American at Colorado in the late 1930s. And those were just the headliners of a remarkable bevy of records gathered by Barry Sanders in 1988. Play.
Pitches back to Sanders. Sweeping right. 20, 15, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown,
there's the
Cowboys! Touchdown.
There's the NCAA record touchdown. He is now the all-time.
Receipt of the Heisman Trophy speaks eloquently for Barry Sanders' accomplishments in 1988. But the award recognizes the achievements of just one season. Barry Sanders' performance in 1988 was one for all time.
Tom, all the people at Oklahoma State's proud of Barry Sanders, and obviously it is once in a lifetime because there are not many backs that come along that can be compared to Barry Sanders.
It's fun to dip into the archives and pull that out. You never get tired of watching that.
No, you don't, because I've gotten to know Barry a little bit, and not only is he a great football player, but he's a special person.
You know, we talked about a lot of guys who gave every fiber of their being to this program. We're going to meet one here this week. Senior Khary Jackson, he was in the middle of most of that action at Lubbock. And we're going to visit with the Cowboy tight end when we return to the Bob Simmons Show.
Now it's time for the Big Time Sports Apparel Player Spotlight. Each week we feature the Cowboy who typifies the big time attitude to dig down deeper. This week's Cowboy in the Player Spotlight is Khary Jackson. Congratulations, when you wear big time, dig down deeper.
Welcome back to the show, and indeed, Khary Jackson visits with us here on the Big Time Player Spotlight. And Khary, we were talking a little bit before the show. You're winding down your career here at Oklahoma State. How do you want to be remembered by the fans here?
Well, basically by the fans, I want to be remembered that, you know what I'm saying, I was a hard worker. I just played my role. You know, if I wasn't getting the ball, I just blocked, you know what I'm saying, whatever I had to do to help the team out, basically.
You appreciate players who work hard in and out of the classroom.
Well, Tom, I do. When you talk about the classroom, Khary is on track to graduate. I really think that he's going to be done at the end of this year. I think there's one class that they need to get out of the way, but he's done a great job in the classroom. Khary is a player that obviously I think will have an opportunity to go to the next level. And our tight ends have not caught many balls, and we've talked about how you get drafted or what people look at. And his dedication to the offense has not been questioned. He's done a great job blocking, and occasionally he's caught a lot of balls, caught some balls these last couple of ball games.
You talk about dedication. Each and every game you played was dedicated, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was very dedicated. Dedicated to one of my friends I lost in high school named Frank Miles. He was our running back in high school, and he got shot, and I was standing right there next to him. And, you know, that bullet could have hit me. So basically every time I go out there, I write his number on my wrist that I get taped and just say, rest in peace, number 23, and just go out there. And every time I play or catch the ball, I think about him. Think about his family. Think about what I could have not had if something would have happened to me if I was in his shoes.
And your major is what?
Sociology. I'm planning on going into law enforcement after this semester. Work with narcotics in Detroit.
I feel like I'm in an infirmary here because we've documented your knee problem. And you got hurt in the game this weekend.
Yeah, twisted my ankle. The second play of the game, I got rolled up from the behind. But I just stayed in and I kept playing. And then third quarter, it happened again, and I just couldn't even run no more. But, you know, even when I was out there catching the ball and out there blocking, I was hurt the whole time. But I felt like, you know what I'm saying, we had to win this game, and I was going to do anything I could just to stay in here and help the team any way I could.
Before we let you go, two more games left on the regular season, then he gets a chance to make a trip that a lot of people like to make to Honolulu, I guess, right?
Well, I don't know for sure, Tom. That's something that we'll talk about at the end of the year. But I know that we got several seniors mm-hmm. that will have opportunities to visit different bowl games. And I think Khary will be one that they will look at.
Well, great effort while you're here. Appreciate you coming down on the show this week. We're going to come back to wrap it all up after this final timeout.
Highest payload capacity. Largest interior.
Welcome back to the show. Baylor in town this weekend, 1 o'clock kickoff. We got a lot of people, including yourself, bumped up.
Yep, Tom, Brian Blackwood and Phillips are injured, but I expect those guys to be back. Very important ball game. Really enough fans to come out and support us.
Well, remember, 1 o'clock kickoff, Lewis Field, Oklahoma State and Baylor. That's all the time we have for this week's show. For Bob Simmons, our entire crew here at Educational Television Services, Tom Dirato. Goodbye, everybody.
The Bob Simmons Show.